So we all know that thermal paste is important because the surface of a CPU and also the heatsink will always have very tiny microscopic bumps and pits in them. That's a natural part of the manufacturing process, of course, but thermal paste actually helps to fix these little micro impurities, and because tin conducts heat, all of the toasty temperatures from the CPU can be better passed up to the CPU cooler and heatsink. So if some crazy idiot decides to use isopropyl wipes to remove all of the thermal paste, there's no real fridge for all of that heat to move from the CPU to the heatsink. So what exactly does happen then? Well, when I first booted up, my computer sounded like it was about to take off because all the fans were running at 100% speed. They were completely maxed out. I then booted into Windows itself and noticed a bit of lag, so naturally opened up HW Info to check the temperature stats, and this was genuinely the face that I pulled. I was genuinely a bit scared because my PC sounded unhealthy due to the fans, and I'd never actually seen temps maxing out to 90 degrees Celsius at idle before. I mean, they did only average 71 degrees for the first 10 minutes or so after turning my PC on, which in some ways isn't too bad, I guess. But that's still very high for a desktop PC with a good quality Noctua cooler. But because I'm a mad lad, I then decided to do some 4K gaming in Sniper Elite before running some stress tests, and this is where the problems actually started. You know, actually using the PC. So I loaded up Sniper Elite 5 and I had all the graphical settings maxed out. Also, I had VSync enabled, and this game usually maxes out at 60fps with no problems at all, but I did start seeing FPS drops quite frequently. I even missed a few shots here and there, which was nothing to do with my lack of ability. Honest, it was just totally down to the missing thermal paste. Early on, I saw FPS drops down to the low 50s, and later on, I saw frame rates in the 40s. While this might not sound too bad for 4K gaming, especially since I was running with zero thermal paste, after all, it's still actually quite low considering I usually get 80 to 90fps when disabling VSync. In other words, I was seeing half the frame rates in this case. I kept track of the CPU temps using HW Info by resetting the counts before launching the game, and you can see the temperatures averaged around 88 degrees, and peaked at a whopping 96 degrees Celsius. The maximum operating temperature of this actual Ryzen CPU, the 5900X, is 90 degrees, so clearly this wasn't good. I'll talk about whether these really high temperatures could have actually damaged my CPU later, but I wanted to quickly show the other two test results first. So next up, I ran the torture test in Prime 95. Young at heart PC builders like me will naturally already know of Prime 95, but if you've never heard of it before, it's basically a free stress testing tool that maxes out your CPU, so you can test out overclocks and system stability. Actually, I say that it maxes out your CPU at 100%. It turns out that if you total pillock, like me, and you remove all of your CPU's thermal paste, a variety of safety measures within the actual motherboard actually kick in and stops the CPU from running at its maximum speed of 100%. In other words, the 100% CPU test that I was trying to run was only resulting in below 40% CPU usage. Notice how the frequency is just 1.4 GHz too? Well, this CPU is meant to run up to 4.8 GHz at boost, so what gives? Well, this is thermal throttling. People talk about it a lot, but you can actually see a clear example of it now on screen. My CPU temperatures were running at 90 degrees Celsius, as you can see over in HW Info, and because this is the maximum rated temp for the CPU, my motherboard's thermal protections actually kicked in and downclocked the CPU. It's essentially doing the opposite of Intel Turbo or AMD Precision Boost, which naturally makes the CPU run faster as long as the CPU isn't too hot. So that's kind of interesting and explains exactly why I actually started to see FPS drops in Sniper Elite 5 too, because while that's a GPU-heavy process, because, you know, it's a game, there will still be various CPU processing actually required for that game, and the CPU was being throttled all the way down. Finally, I did a 4K video render in Premiere Pro, and this always stresses my system out a lot, more so than Prime 95, in fact. CPU temps again hit an average of 90 degrees with a peak of 91, and while video rendering usually maxes out my CPU, in this case it was only around 50 to 60% usage with a frequency of below 3 GHz. So again, thermal throttling actually took place. You can literally see the point in time when the throttling protections kicked in too, which is pretty cool. So Premiere Pro started ramping up and CPU usage was heading to 100% as expected, but because temperatures then got too high, the CPU frequency immediately fell from over 4 GHz down to under 3. So that's actually pretty interesting to see. The Ryzen CPU comes hard-coded with a max operating temperature, and then the motherboard actually helps to enforce this limit by making the CPU a massive bottleneck, essentially. There was actually a time when you could disable this protection in the BIOS, but nowadays the option has been removed, thankfully. If I had been able to disable it somehow, then my CPU probably would have ended up getting damaged or even bricked. My motherboard's VRM might also have been damaged in the process. Luckily though, these failsafes are in place to protect both the CPU and the motherboard. It doesn't seem to have been any long-term damage due to me running my computer for an hour or so without any thermal paste whatsoever. I've done lots of 4K gaming and video editing since these actual tests, and I haven't had any crashes, so fingers crossed I'm good. Maybe if I tried originally running Prime95 for days on end, something might have eventually got damaged, but this is my main PC, I love it, and so I really wasn't willing to actually run it for a week or more without him. I should also point out that while I only use an air cooler for this computer, the super high temps I experienced were 100% down to the lack of thermal paste. My air cooler is actually a highly engineered noctuate beast and it leads to some really low temperatures. In general, when I actually have thermal paste, my idle temps are 39 degrees and this then rises to the 50s and 60s in my other tests. So the fact that I was seeing 90 degree temps shows just how important thermal paste actually is. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.